teen dating violence. What educators need to know. The facts. One out of every three teens reports experiencing some kind of abuse in their romantic relationships. According to a statewide survey, 75% of 16 to 24-year-old Texans have either personally experienced dating violence or know someone who has. All members of the school community have important roles in preventing dating violence and promoting healthy relationships. Dating violence is the intentional use of physical, sexual, verbal, or emotional abuse by a person to harm, threaten, intimidate, or control another person in a dating relationship.
Dating violence is not just hitting. It can include yelling, threatening, name-calling, obsessive phone calling or texting, extreme possessiveness, controlling behavior, pressuring to have sex or do something you do not want to do.
What can you do to help a student in an unhealthy relationship? Tell the person who is being abused that you are concerned for his or her safety. Acknowledge the abuse is not the person's fault. Listen, be supportive and patient. Do not judge or criticize. Help the person develop a safety plan that focuses on preventing future harm. Never confront the abuser. This could be dangerous. Encourage the person to talk to others who can provide help and guidance.
Who can you ask for help? School counselor or administrator. Domestic violence abuse agencies. SRO. School resource officer. Child protective services. Or have them call 911 if they're in immediate danger.
Educators should always intervene in an appropriate and consistent way in order to respect the privacy of students. Preventing dating violence can be achieved by modeling respectful behavior and mutual respect in dating relationships. Encourage students to strive for healthy dating relationships that are based on friendship, mutual respect, open communication, positive conflict resolution, trust, and encouragement. Remember, if students come to you about an abusive dating relationship, help is available.
If you are the trusted adult, you should fulfill the state's mandatory reporting laws regarding the suspected abuse or neglect of a child. Separate the victim from the alleged perpetrator. Refer the situation to campus administration. Speak with the victim and alleged perpetrator separately. Administer logical and reasonable consequences to the alleged perpetrator when appropriate, including but not limited to making a discipline referral. Inform the victim of his or her right to file a complaint. And monitor the victim's safety. It is critical that adults who surround teenagers in school, teachers, counselors, and administrators, recognize the warning signs of teen dating violence.
I never thought I would be a victim of dating violence. It didn't start out that way. Then, over time, it got worse. I kept telling myself that it wasn't that bad and he didn't mean to hurt me. He usually apologized later and told me that he loved me. One day, my best friend saw him hit me. She got me to realize that it was that bad. I felt relieved that I could finally talk to someone about it. My friend convinced me to talk to a trusted adult. It was hard because I really thought that I loved him. They made me see that what was happening was not my fault. With help, I got out of the relationship. There were times I was really scared. Now I know that I did the right thing. I cannot control the other person. I can only control myself. No one deserves to be a victim of dating violence. I see that now. If you or someone you know is in a dating violence situation, tell someone, get help. You deserve better.